6. Network curated content. The average quality and reliability of listings is higher than in the usual OTAs. It's curated by the network in a decentralized way. For guests, this means a better experience. This part is still not clear to me. I'm still wondering why OTAs accept anyone when it's clear that bad actors or non-performant users, especially hosts, are an expense. And I think it's because it's cheaper to let the guests evaluate places and hosts rather than do it yourself as an OTA, which could be very, very expensive. So you're actually using your guests as guinea pigs to say, okay, it could be a very bad place. Sometimes it's obvious it's a bad place because the pictures, because of the description, you can see that behind this listing, there's not really somebody who wants to do a good job, but just maybe a quick money grab. And well, they still let guests get in, have a bad experience, have their holiday spoiled, and then leave a bad review, and then kick this listing out. We are going to make the effort and go through the expense of actually vetting every single listing. And actually, Airbnb before the pandemic said that they were gonna check every single listing, so they kind of decided that's a better attitude. And we will do this in a decentralized way. People will, we will do it ourselves as a network. And and so we can guarantee a better quality for our guests. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, or share. You can comment in YouTube, LinkedIn, or directly in the Google Docs white paper page. Thank you for watching.